serpent thing that creepeth upon the earth. So God created a man in his own image, and the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. And then in Genesis 2, let's see here. And the Lord God, Genesis 2:7, and the Lord God formed man of the dust of ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. And the Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he had formed. And it's very clear to me that man was created, formed out of the dust of the ground with his flesh body before he ever sinned. And so if someone says that God created us to be souls first and then gave us a flesh after we sinned, that's not what it says. So I don't agree with that. Good grief, there's another one. Hi, guys. Here's another one. Hi. Odessa says, Pastor Mike, even Elijah told Israel to choose this day who they would serve, God or Baal on Mount Carmel. There's this pseudo-intellectual spirit that I've always loathed with Calvinism. Either you believe the whole word of God or you don't. Or we are truly in the days of Noah. Odessa, I appreciate that. Here's another one. Good grief. Here we go. Let's see here. Do we got any more stupid people? Yeah, there's another one. Man. Anyway. You guys, knock that off. You're like so wasting your breath on me today, I guarantee ya. Okay? Why don't you go sign up illegal aliens to vote, okay? Go spend your time on that instead of wasting your time on me. Good grief. Chemo says, hey, Pastor Mike, saw the movie Elysium. I got my eye on this one. I saw the preview of it, and I'm going, I know what that is. This past weekend, and then saw your latest WVB, the Comic Con. It was interesting that you mentioned regeneration being the key to immortality in the agenda of the coming world system. In the movie, it shows the marking of a code in the right arm, then using a medical bed authorized by the code DNA in the right arm to cure whatever problem your body is facing in order to live longer. Also, the dying god, Matt Damon. That demon guy. Yeah. Matt Damon. He was Jason Bourne. Now, I got to say, the Jason Bourne movies were awesome. Okay. But anyway. That's my flesh, I know. Also the dying god who was exposed to radiation and facing imminent death in 5 days. He takes on a suit like a droid to enhance his abilities, like the Iron Man. At the end of the movie, he dies to save all mankind, to allow them to become citizens of Elysium so that all will be allowed to receive the mark to use the med bed to heal all infirmities and so on. Let's see here. There were a lot of other things, like Elysium being in the form of a pentagram and having a circle within a circle. Just wanted to share this. I'm probably not going to see it at the movie, but I'm going to get this movie when it comes out, and you'll be hearing from me on this. I guarantee you. Carson. Pastor Mike, I love you, man. Love you back, Jack. However, let me say, according to Scripture, there's none that doeth good, and though man has a choice, this choice has no part in salvation. Quote Scripture. Question, what choice did you have in your physical birth? None. What choice do you suppose that you have in your spiritual birth? Now, see, you're giving me an intellectual argument with no scripture. You show me scripture that says I have no choice in my spiritual birth. Show me the scriptures. Don't give me your intellectual garbage. Don't give me your intellectual stuff. I don't mean to be mean to you. I love you, man. I do. But that idea is not biblical. It's not there. So if you want to present this to me, and I am all willing to hear you out scripturally, but if you want to present this to me, Don't give me philosophical arguments. Don't say, well, let's reason this and this and this and this. Give me scripture that says that you don't get a choice to be saved. Show me the verse. Show me the verse. And actually, you'll need to. Anyway, let me see. Pastor Mike, should I stay away from the book of Enoch? Absolutely. Don't read it. It's junk. It's going to lead you astray.
Beware of the blob. And leaps and glides and
slides
across the floor, right through the door, all around the
house. Any more? I'm looking for the trolls. Now, I got about 9. Oh, here's another one. Here's another one. Good grief. Go sign up some illegal aliens, all right? Don't waste your time on me anymore. I'm not going to read any more of your stupid emails. It's probably the same person. I love you. You need to be saved. You need Jesus Christ in your heart. You need to repent of your sins. That's what you need to do. Don't waste your time trying to aggravate me. Get saved before it's too late. See ya.